calamity. 5
verse 5 and verse 6. Lodo itabala situ braha.
Psalm 85
verse 5 and verse 6.
He said, "Will thou be angry with us forever? Will thou draw out thine anger to all generations?" Next verse. He said, "Will thou not revive us again, that thy power may rejoice in thee?" Briefly, I want to share what I titled, "Revive Us Again."
Oh.
What the church of God needs today is the power of revival. Ladies and gentlemen, when I was giving my life to Christ, they told me stories about how God has used men of old. They told me stories of how certain men met the lame man by the beautiful gate, and Peter said, "God and Silver I am none, such as I have I give to thee, rise up and walk." And he that was crippled began to walk. Ladies and gentlemen, where is the power that they told us about? Where are the manifestations that we saw in the Act of the Apostles? We have pastors today who know how to tie and dress with suit, but their hands are void of power. We have members today who know how to go to church consistently. They have become religious people and they lack the power therein. I came to raise men. I came to raise women who are angry with their dress code without power to show. I came to raise men of power in this generation. People who will see madmen pass and they will look for the madman to heal. I came to raise men. Where is the power that Moses manifested? Where is the power that Elijah manifested? Where is the power that Elisha manifested? Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, "You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come." Yes, and some have received the Holy Ghost, yet we have not seen power. Some have received the Holy Ghost, yet we have not seen manifestation. Some have received the Holy Ghost, yet they are still stranded. In the next 48 hours, there is a power coming. There is a heaven open. There is a hand coming. In the Father, you will not manifest. From today, go. You shall be a power manifestation. You shall be the power of God. You shall carry the power of God. Oh Lord, revive us again. Oh Lord, revive us again. Oh Lord, revive us again. Push on the motion, revival. Give me volume. Where is the power that we were spoken to about? Ladies and gentlemen, do you know it's an error to see a madman pass and you as a powerful believer, you didn't do anything? The Bible says they asked the disciples, disciples asked Jesus in John. He said, "This man that was born blind, who did he offend?" And the Bible said, Jesus replied them, "He never offended the father, he never offended the mother, but that the name of God should be glorified." How can you say you're an ambassador of God and you don't have the reasons, or there are no things you do to glorify the name of God? Am I speaking to somebody here? If you read the book of Jeremiah 8 from verse 20 to 22, the Bible says Jeremiah began to cry. He said, "For the reasons, for the daughters of my people, am I crying? I am not crying because I have no deliverance. I am crying because I'm a deliverer. Yet I see a demon possessed person. The person leaves me the same way he comes." Am I communicating here? He said, "For the tears of the daughters of my people, am I weeping?" Ladies and gentlemen, a time comes in your Christian walk when you become embarrassed with a problem and you prove to people that you got a solution, and a solution you can't give to the problem. Am I communicating here? Yes, I came to raise pastors who are angry with their present level and they want to change their into destiny. I came to raise people who are angry seeing their face on billboard and after the meeting ain't no testimony to show. If you're among those people about to change level today, by the power of grace, you will receive power in your hands. I said, "You will carry power in your hands." I said, "You will carry power in your hands." The Bible says, "You shall lay your hands on the sick, and the sick shall
Yes.
Am I communicating here?
Oh.
Stretch your hand, make I give you power. Stretch your hand, make I give you power. All these hands stretch toward this altar. By the time this service comes to an end, it shall be endued with power. It shall be canonized with power. It shall be engraved with power. And you shall power, 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 power. Revivals again. Revivals again. Revivals again. Revivals again. Revivals
again.
Listen, in verse 22 of Jeremiah 8, the Bible says, and Jeremiah cried. He said, is there no balm in Gilead? He said, are there no physicians there? How can you come from a family? Everybody's a destitute. Is there no balm in that family? Are there no physicians there? How can you come from a location? You claim to have the power of God, and witches are still oppressing people. Is there no balm in Gilead? Are there no physicians there? How can you come from a village? You go to the village, nobody feel a general has come. Is there no balm in Gilead? Are there no physicians there? How can your family be poor when you serve a God that is rich? Is there no balm in Gilead? Are there no physicians there? Ladies and gentlemen, we came to carry balm into our families. We came to carry balm into our communities. If your presence does not make an impact, your absence will not make a difference.
Yes,
from
sir.
Today, anywhere you enter, you will make impact in destiny. You will make impact in ministry. You will make impact around your life. And you run out of your seat and shout, revive us again.
Revive us again.
Shout it one more time. Say, revive us again.
Revive us again.
The Bible is not looking like a story. Somebody will wear glass in his eyes and read the Bible and be telling you that Caleb was 180 and was not blind. Moses was 180 and was not blind. The Bible said his eyes were not feeble.
Yes, sir.
The person preaching to you is wearing glass to say it. That's hypocrisy. You are telling people that God is good. Is your life good? You are telling people that the God who blessed me will bless you. Are you blessed? Why say the things that you are not to people?
Oh,
it's hypocrisy.
Good message.
Revive us again. If the revival was good for Paul and Silas, it should also be good for me.
Oh.
If it was good for Mary and Martha, it can also be good for me. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the ancient days where power is raw, but yet there is no man to manifest the power.
Yes, sir.
Is God stingy with power? No, sir. He said you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come. The Holy Ghost has come on you because you are speaking in tongue. Mark 16, 17 and 18. He said, this sign shall follow them that believe. There must be a proof. And one of the proof, he said, they will speak with new tongues. My brother, you are speaking in tongues. Disturbing your neighbors. A sick person is in the house. Your hands cannot heal them. It's hypocrisy.
Yes, sir.
It's hypocrisy. My God is a healer. My God is a this. My God is a that. You are just castigating something you know nothing about. The kingdom of God is not in word, but in the manifestation of power. For the earnest expectation of the creator waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. We have pastors who cannot see vision. My brother, close your church and enter your house. We have preachers who cannot prophesy. Close your church and go to your village. The difference should be clear. Your eyes are not just there as decoration. When you shut them, the other one should open. But the problem is that the church is not comfortable. In the olden days, they were in the upper room. In this generation, we are in the supper room.
Oh.
Churches in Europe are not being sustained by serving tea and serving bread. People don't go to church to see power. Then a pastor now changed the dimension because he has been preaching power that people don't see. He's not preaching bread. He's not preaching love. He calls it grace message. He will preach bread. He will say no need to fight because he cannot fight. Because I know my God. He teacheth my hand to war and my finger to fight. I am a man of Messiah. He said, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but the mighty true God in the pulling down of stronghold, casting an imagination of everything that is wrought in my mama. I came to prophesy. With this mouth I used to pray. You will see the power of God this morning. You will see the power of God this morning. You will see the power of God this morning. God has sent me to come and raise a worshiper that will pick up my to worship. Even after the before the worship continues, people already fall under the anointing. Why? Because the kingdom of God is not in words. Am I speaking to somebody here?
Yes, sir.
Revival tarries because men are not ready. Revival is not coming because men are not ready. Little breakthrough, your prayer life dropped. You are not ready. To be consistent as somebody, listen to me. Some of those pastors whose churches closed, they were doing well at the initial stage. They were very popular at the initial stage. But have you sat down to bother or to wonder, why did their church close? What started them? They left that thing. And that thing that started them stopped them. You knew before you mad pulpits, 3 hours, you are still praying. You knew before you pick mic to worship, 1 hour you speak in tongue, because you know the Bible says he that speak in an unknown tongue edifies himself. But today, it is from Facebook you came to church. Tell them. Watching YouTube, watching other people's preaching. My brother, to preach other people's preaching is not to move the power of God the way others move their own. Because the power of God can only move on the platform of your self-developed rhema. Your self-developed knowledge is what gives God power to move. The best you can be if somebody's message you preach is number two. And God does not work with number two. When you are preaching as a number two, you are an actor. Actors has no kudos because they are preaching a script. But show me a man who has sat down, take time to study like Paul said to Timothy. Study to show thyself approve. The approval of power does not come until you study yourself. Revive us again. I am tired of coming to church and nobody is touched by the power of God. I am tired of going to programs and nobody comes back to testify. Lord, revive us again. I need a reviver. You need a reviver. The church of God needs a reviver. The people of God needs a reviver. And the Bible says, I search for a man who will stand in the gap, who will mediate between humanity and divinity. And I look into the crowd. People are not angry yet. People are not angry yet. You have to get holy anger for you to get a manifestation. Today I say this to you. You are standing too long on this mountain. It's time to move ahead. It's time to change dimension. I prophesy to your life. Your hands will move the power of God.
Am I speaking to someone?
Yes, sir. Sit down. Years ago, under the banner of Catholic Charismatic Renewal, we went to a program called Pentecost. It used to happen in the April time of the year. I don't know if they have shifted it. But this Pentecost is a gathering of people where the Spirit of God is prayed into them. And they used to have numerous speakers. Ladies and gentlemen, I was privileged to be in one meeting where one brother who is dead now, His name is Brother Imagwezeji. He's from a place they call Igwebe. This man was in the meeting to minister. He was not the guest speaker. The guest speaker was preaching when rain started falling. And the rain was so heavy. In April, the rain was so heavy that canopies were removed. And the guest speaker said, okay, this is how God wants it to be. Let's close the meeting now. The Holy Ghost, he said the Holy Ghost told him to close the meeting. Brother Magwazije came outside. He says, sir, with due respect, it's a lie. Give me the mic. And the guy came on the center of the field and said, rain, hold your peace. The rain, zip up. The rain, stop falling. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, don't let your condition give you revelation. Oh. If your condition give you revelation, you can't do manifestation.
Yes, sir.
I'm communicating with somebody here.
Yes, sir.
He came out and stopped the rain. And while the guy was preaching, the guy made a statement. He said, before everyone here, this is my last message with you. A few weeks later, the man died. People of power, people of revival, they are not everywhere, they are somewhere. People of power. We have heard a lot of things. You know, Mama was preaching just now. Mama talked about how prophets manifested, how Elisha parted the Jordan River, how Elijah did the same thing. These are power manifestation. These are ability to stop the mouth of marine. But ladies and gentlemen, you've been praying and still here. The woman still comes to sleep with you in the night. You've been fasting yet. The man still comes to sleep with you in your dreams. Why? The Bible says, why are the mighty falling? Tell it not in Gath. Publish it not in the streets of Ascalon. Lest the daughters of the Philistines rejoice. Lest the daughters of the uncircumcised exult. Ladies and gentlemen, let me leave you with this fire. When you get back home, you are looking for a native doctor to challenge. Because it's better to die for something than to live for nothing. Let me leave you with this power. When you get back to the office, that married woman has no reason to remain the same way. When he comes to the office with charm, he should go home with stroke.
Yes.
Oh, revive us again. We need a revival. Revive us again. Revive us again. Revive us again. We've heard of great servants of God who entered into aircraft. Even the pilot fell under the anointing. Who was not flying the plane? We heard of it, but we have not seen it with our eyes. It was proof producing. We heard of it. Allen, one of the greatest healing evangelists. No matter how your legs are bent, if you meet with A.A. Allen, you must walk. Smith Wigglesworth, he goes to mortuary to wake up dead bodies. He will go there and just knock on the door. Bang! They will open for him. He will raise all of them up. Oh yeah, run. A man start telling dead body to run. How many can we talk about? There is a man who is my father's mentor in the prophetic. His name is William Marion Braham.
Oh.
This man will come to church. He will stand there and be saying, there is somebody here, there is somebody here, there is somebody here. Or your name is this. No, no, no. The whole church will be on the queue. He will tell you where you came from. He will tell you who you are. He will tell you your problem. He will tell you where you are going. He will take the problem and put it in his pocket. The whole church, not one person, not five people, the whole church. And then we are saying the glory of the latter house is supposed to be greater than that of the former. When we have the stories of the former and we have no proof in the latter, we have stories to tell, we have no power to manifest. Oh my God, I don't know who I came here for, but I'm hungry for power. I want to be drunk. I want to be filled. Stand up, man. Dalasa. I am tired. 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 Oh God, let your power fall. Let there be a revival. Let there be a changing of the spirit. Lord, align me to power. Align me to your will. I am tired of coming to church and ministry. People go back the same way. No, sir. No, sir. No, sir. Oh God, revive us.
Sit down. Sit down.
He said, because of the daughters of my people, am I hot? He said, I'm not hot because the Bible also said, he said, I am black and astonished. But I'm not hot. I'm hot because I have a member believing God to settle, and I'm praying, and the person is not settling. I am hot because there is a cripple, and I've read that the cripples lame walk, blind see, and yet they are not happening. Churches where miracles happen, legit miracles, not acted miracles, are few, very few. In fact, very, very few. We know all these things. Too few, because men are not available. You know what David said? In a dry and a thirsty land, where there is no water, my soul thirsted for you, my spirit longeth after thee, to see thy power, to see thy glory, my brother. Is it not a shame that you lay your hand on the sick that should recover, the sick refuse to recover? At the shame. Is it not a shame that at least something wants to happen, you could not perceive it at all? Your eyes have become blind and photostated that you cannot even see beyond your nose. My brother, you don't need to be a prophet to see. Seeing is our birthright. I'm telling you the truth. Seeing is our birthright. You are created to see. Sometimes the reason why God cannot open your eyes to see physically and start giving you so much dream is because your flesh has not died and tuned to his channel. So he chose to allow you die in the sleep to give you dreams. People who prophesy very well, they don't dream too much.
Yes, sir.
They don't dream too much. If they dream once, it's because it's an emergency. They don't dream too much. I'm talking about legitimate prophets. This is why you sleep and you are seeing season film. You can come and start telling us five movies as a dream. In how many hours you slept? It's a sign that physically you are not seeing anything. So God bottles up the revelation I give to you. And the more they dream, the more you are confused. It's too much. Season film. I now come and see myself going to Opposite Junction. As I reach there, then I say I should turn. As I thought, your dream is too messed up. It's too messed up. It's like a career. No, sir. No, sir. Paul said, in the dream of the night, he saw men telling him, come to so and so. Definite dream. But check your dream. Sir, I was sleeping. I now saw myself in Opposite Junction. I was trekking. My brother, they have finished you.
Yes, sir.
No direction, no definition. Revive us! Again. We are in a generation where recruits is on the altar and general is sitting down. Revive us again. The days of going to the bush to pray, revive us again. The days of weeping all through the night, pray for the power of God, revive us again. Ladies and gentlemen, I came for a reviver. I didn't come to amuse you. If you want to go home, go home. But I came for a reviver. Because at the later part of your life, it is your power that God has given you and your manifestation that will give you a platform. Your manifestation. That will give you a platform. Am I speaking to somebody?
Yes,
I was
sir.
In Redeemed Camp to pray, and a testimony was shared of a woman that has no womb, but she gave birth to triplets. How? She had had an abortion and they cut off her womb. She confessed it. She showed proof. But look at triplets, because a word came from the altar. And this word was not a charismatic word. Baba said, I should tell you. It's not how you say it. It's what backs what you say. Baba said, I should tell you. It doesn't run around the altar. His altar is not even as big as our own. The way we run around. Relay. At the end, you have headache for nothing. Nothing for no just cause. And there are men. Ayabalakasa. He was, that the Jew was going to Port Harcourt to preach. And his fuel finished on the way. He told his driver, peace inside the tank. Peace inside. The driver, peace be inside the tank. They started the motor. Motor started. The brother. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? God God's servant Hubert Angel, they brought a phone that was dead. Dead phone, scrap phone. He put his hand, phone came alive. Television that was broken was brought to church. He heard the television, commanded it to on. Without being connected to power, television on. Forget this thing. Forget this thing. Evil Satan has his dimension in magic. Satan get his size. Satan, he get a level. He get where he reach. He get a level. Where he reach day. Where he reach day. Saw him pray for a woman that was having obesity. In our eyes, stomach began to go inside. Somebody who came with a big skirt not let her wear again. He hold her tie and rapper. Power as of old. And then we in Nigeria, it's like the sun shining here is even taking power from us. I went with a priest to a harvest in a place they call Eko Yobibi. As we are there, the father said, we want to do this, we want to do that. And the rain is about to fall. Our guests will not come. I told father, rain will not fall. The place was dark. I said, father, rain will not fall. If a native doctor can hold rain, what of you? What of you? What of you? I'm telling the truth. One of my friend's sister was getting married. Am I even speaking to somebody at all? My friend's sister was getting married. And I went there to pray and I told them, rain is going to fall, but let's pray and fast. I'll be on the fast and there will not be rain. And I went to the house. They put me in the room. I was there. I said, you go and ease myself. As I came outside, I met that a native doctor was behind the house with bottle of schnapps, four corner, and food and mineral. The guy was high and the guy was eating. He would just carry some schnapps, put it in the mouth and blow it in the air. They believed the prophecy that rain will fall. But instead of relying on me to hold the rain, they brought a native doctor. Me, I was fasting. The guy was eating outside. My brother, I went back to the room. I didn't even use myself again. Took a bottle of Fanta. As you did chop, made me set the chop. The moment I started gulping it, rain started. It was not him. He was paid, but was not doing the job. I was not paid, but I was in charge of the job. Immediately, it started raining. That's the day I knew that you don't need the skies to be black for rain to fall. If rain were for my brother, it go fall. It started raining. They were shouting, canopies were moving everywhere. I came out with my bottle of Fanta. Go. How can you serve two masters at the same time?
No,
you can't conquer any native doctor. We are not in the same dimension. And brother, when Ray beat that native doctor with all the gum and everything, I'm a damn nearly. The truth of the matter is that they that know their God shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Let me introduce to you the God whom you serve. He sits on the sacrifice of himself.
Yes,
and the sons of men are as grasshopper. He walks upon the wings of the wind as a chariot. He stretched for the heaven as a curtain. He created barrier between water and land. I said water should not return to the land. I call him the almanac of mass creation. He's the monarch of the universe. He's the chief alahaji of all alahajis.
Yes,
somebody shout Jesus. Says in Philippians 2 from verse 5, I say it all the time. He said, let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself unto death, even the death of the cross. He said, wherefore God has exalted him and has given him a name that's above every other name. But he said, at the name of Jesus, he didn't say at the mention. The Bible never said at the mention of the name. If you mention the name, power will not function. Mentioning the name means you know the name because it is popular. But if it is at the name, that means the name is what is backing everything you say. You don't have to say the name of Jesus anymore. It is done. But because it's coming from a crock where the name is the foundation, it functions. When people send me tests, I stop sending them in the name of Jesus. I said, it is done, or God intervene. Why? Because every statement I have spoken like that
is coming from the foundation, which is Jesus. Powers of old. Where is the revival that we read about? My brother, are you not ashamed? If you know the shame, I'm ashamed for you now. Where is the revival that you know the church now is full of protection prayer? You know, we have to protect ourselves. Protection. It is full of protection prayer because armies do not know that they are armies. You're not aware again that you are a soldier. It is army against army. The battle is set in array. People don't understand anymore. Let me tell you the truth. Something happened some years ago, and I saw a pastor did it, and I also tried to do it. What did I see? Because I'm always provoked when I see something I can do and somebody else is doing it. It provokes me to pray. This guy was 19 years old, and the guy prophesied to 46 people in one meeting without making mistake. My brother, one of the strengths and the weakness of a prophet is his ability to know that God has stopped speaking and stop. I wish I was talking to somebody. You should know when it is lifted and stop talking. Because if you continue talking, you'll be talking in error. But this guy spoke to over 40 persons and didn't make mistake. Called their lineage, described everything about them and told them what God is here to do. But bro, what has happened to your ears? All you are hearing is hunger. They beat me. Oh, hunger. They beat me. Hey! Why not hunger for power? Why not hunger? Revive us again. Lord, revive us. Revive us again! Revive us. If I were you now, I can't sit in this man with one butos or two butos anymore. I will just arrange myself like who wants to run. Lord, revive us again. Revive us. I was sharing with my brother in the US. I was talking to him yesterday. We were doing some prayer together, speaking in tongues. I was talking to him. I said, bros, you know the sisters, you know. He said to me, man of God, I don't tire. You see, young people are manifesting God now. And those old bishops, they don't have big stomach. They will not wear bishop tie. My brother, power does not respect your tie. Power of God is not in that your white tie you wear. If you are wearing that white tie, you are deceiving yourself. Power is not in the bishop cap. That cap is evil deception. Some years ago, I was in a marriage, and it was a church, denominational church, and the senior man came and said, "Did he introduce him where that he will not sit and he's going?" I carried my Bible, told my guy to follow me. Let's go. They didn't call your reverend doctor. My brother, you are a native doctor. You are not a reverend doctor. Who is reverencing you? You even know what is reverend? You know what is reverend? You think reverend is just a title? Title without mantle is a battle. You call yourself big name. When your enemies come, when you call yourself apostle, get ready for apostolic enemies. Because every new stage that you get to attracts new enemies. What is your name? I am Bishop so and so. I remember, maybe it's me, a bishop that went to Deeper Life Camp to preach, to pray. As we were there to pray, we met two small more young child. They were praying and I was encouraged. What discouraged me about them? I asked them, oh, what's your name? The smallest one say, I'm apostles. Ah! Well, no, it's way. The other one say, I'm evangelist. So I say, guy. People who are conscious of title, they don't have mantles. It is your mantle that gives you a name. Sometimes people call me prophet. Why? Because of maybe the prophetic gift. So the different name. Because what you do is what gives you a name. You can't see somebody under the motto and he's using spanner to jack something, and then you're calling the person doctor. No. With the job he does, he's a mechanic. Better one. But my brother, you're not able to do anything. Sing, you know if you sing. Preach, you know if you preach. And then you carry one big boroka ring. Intimidating people with the ring. Don't you see? I went to Stephen's shop to buy equipment. And a man came down from back with white gown and red cape and bishop cap. And you know what the man said? He was asking the bike man to give him 10 naira change. He was a bishop. With all those big cross, Jesus' long left cross, the guy still carried cross on his neck. And with big ring, he was telling the man, give me my change. The Bible said, I don't even get change. What? How much? 10 naira change. He said, give me my change. He said, I don't have change. The man was not saying, this guy, you don't know me. We are only 5 bishops in Ekpoma. My brother, if that is bishop, bishop is Detroit, bishop, dirty bishop. Bishop came down from back with his cape and everything. And is you are bold enough to open your mouth and say, we are only 5 bishops in Ekpoma. Instead of you to call yourself small shop. Power! Revive us again. 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 I'm tired of hearing the word and not seeing the proof. Revive us again. Hold the hand of your neighbor. Just not everybody hold one person's hand. Listen to this. I was in Sokoto to preach. Well, some of them are watching us live now. I was in Sokoto to preach. As I was preaching there, the first night I hold mic, I just started preaching, manifesting God like no man's business. And all of a sudden, the woman of God, who is the general overseer of the church, told me to stop. I felt like, is this an embarrassment? He said, stop, sir. He carried mic. He said, who are we inviting in December? The whole church shouted, this man of God. I have not started ministering deep. I was just in the tip of the iceberg, calling cases from their village to their home. I was in Calabar to minister, just like 2 months interval. As I was preaching, the first night, the woman shouted to the crowd, who do we call next year? They said, this man of God. Why? Proof. You know, this word has become the word of Thomas. The Bible calls us the Jonah generation. That if we don't see proof, we won't believe. And you are still preaching with your glass, you will not drop it. The Lord said, we will prosper. You will not put it up again. Can I get water, dear? You will not drink the water, you will not drop it. The Lord said, in this era where Satan is now pressing computer, where Satan has become digital, you are still using analog power. And the Lord said, What is God saying? Some people want to prophesy, they'll be telling you, it's not clear, it's not open. Turn the antenna. If it's not clear, keep quiet. Somebody came and told my wife, he said to her, laugh one wound, injure me, that they wound you, not even injure, wound and injure together, wound you. He said to my wife, you like granite very well. My wife, me, like granite. To encourage the man, yes sir, you bought granite and there's somebody who begged you, didn't give him, give her. He said, we afflict you. My wife, you beg granite. We all clap. People were just, he's not seen anything. And somebody's coming to tell you, I saw a bird flying. Do birds sweep? Don't they fly before? Don't they fly? If you're not seeing, keep quiet. Wait till you start seeing. Lest you deceive yourself into error. To pray, I don't know why I want to pray for power, because this thing has to come. You have just one life to live. You want to live like this? You want to live like this?
No, sir.
You want to live without impact?
No, sir.
When you become too hungry for power, that even in your office people want to buy something and they're asking you, who they say, Zoto Pika Paleta Eka Echo, they should know you for something. I
and Mrs. Sin had about 7 children, my brother, and she was still speaking in tongue 3 hours every day. Don't tell me your children are the reason why you're not praying. 3 hours, zabada, zabada, zab, 3 hours, 3 hours. Mama in Auchi was pregnant, and Papa told us that she still speaks in tongue 3 hours every day. With pregnancy, she will hold the baby. Why won't they flourish? Why won't they go far? It's not just to bear the name. Show me the proof. Are you aware? Before I started ministering, we already have 2,400 views. Are you following me? Before we started preaching just now, those who are viewing us online, how many? 2,400 people. Who are viewing us where? Who was I showing just now? I was showing you. 2,400. All those messages, mama was preaching, everybody, people are viewing. Over 2,400. So you not come to one night and just do yaga, 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 yaga. When people, who are even more times, 20 of those people here, are viewing you live. Not come and mess up. In this generation. Revive us again. Revive us again. Revive us again. We have passed it. Oh God. Oh God. Spirit of God, take me. Spirit of God, take over me. Spirit of God, take over me. Take over me. This level we have, we are more mature than this one. Spirit of God, take over. Are you ready to pray now? Are you sure you are ready?
Yes, sir.
Somebody and begin to pray. Somebody and begin to pray. Lord, I need a revival. Revive us again. Revive us, revive us. Revive us, revive us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
You are not ready. Let me give you 2 things and then you start praying. Listen. Remember, Stadio, listen to me. Listen to me. I went to preach somewhere and I was expecting to meet the crowd inside church, but I met the crowd outside. So I asked the pastor, why are you for outside? He said, because I invited you. I know the church will not contain. Because I invited you, I know the church will not contain. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a good testimony. Where's Chris? Come. I've gone to preach in his church. After the first night, the second night, everywhere became full. Outside became full. Outside the fence became full. They had to destroy church.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so that
sir.
People
yes.
can see us.
Destroy proof. The
destroy the bust it open for people to see. Proof. 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 You may not happy because before you came, but after this night. After this night. That evidence that will surprise you today, carry with your hands, carry, carry. Revive us.
Yeah!
Already, I know there is a revival. Only a revival can bring forth this kind of prayer.
Boy, yeah.
I'm telling you. Oh, Lord,
Romans 8 and 11. He said, if the spirit of him that raised Jesus from the grave lives in me, he said, that same spirit shall vitalize my mortal body.
Colabas, Colades, Osisisisisisisis, no tito lito lila rata, no tito lino tina lima hanate. Recunde King Bahanda Leto Dize Tu Crehenda Ma Holy Ghost Holy Ghost, we don't need any stranger in our hearts. Let it be you and you alone. Let it be you. I'm yielding to your spirit alone, yielding to you and you alone. No stranger in my heart but you. Oh, somebody's getting the revival. You are getting revived. You are getting revitalized.
Spirit of God,
Now listen to me. I read the scripture just now in Romans 8:11. What did I say? Can you put that up on the screen? Everybody listen it. Put that up on Romans 8:11. Romans 8:11. Can you bring it up on the screen, please? Hey, he said, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body by the spirit that dwelleth in you. My brother, the time that your shop died has passed. If you carry a living spirit, your shop should be alive. You didn't get what I said? Business don't die in the hands of those carrying living spirit. He said the first Adam died. Am I correct? But he said the last Adam was a living spirit. He gives life. All those areas of your life. How can you have an account and you have a need and your account cannot meet your need? Your account is dead. Today life will enter. I said life has entered here. Ministry, life has entered. Your calling, life has entered. Your connection, life has entered. Your help dimension, life has entered here. I speak life, 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 life.
Amen.
He said, let Reuben live. In that same vein, I say, let your business thrive. Let your marriage thrive. Let your relationship thrive. Your academics thrive. From hence, in the name of Jesus.
Let this very clear in my ear. But people 21 persons after the service, that in your life that has been